have you join us this evening. This is the fifth year of incubator at Vandegrift. We can't wait to show you what our teams have accomplished over the last couple of years. Let us introduce ourselves. I'm Anushka Modi. And there's going to be a few other seniors who will also be emceeing tonight. We're all high school seniors, and we're all small business owners. Not something you hear every day, right? Last year, we were all in the same shoes as the teams you will see pitching tonight. We have to say, it is a little less stressful in this role. All the accelerator students you see today are representing the colleges they are attending this fall. So you might be wondering, what exactly is Incubator EDU? Incubator blends entrepreneurship lessons with real-world startup experience. Students have the opportunity to create and fully develop their own product or service. Each student team has a real entrepreneur mentor that meets with them weekly throughout the school year to help them develop their business product or app. Industry experts serve as volunteer coaches and teach classroom lessons on the subject of their expertise. These real-world entrepreneurs guide the teams through the processes of turning their ideas into business models, creating a minimum viable product, testing and adjusting their product, and pitching their idea to a panel of judges for funding. Last week, our judges watched all 22 student teams present. They had the difficult task of narrowing it down to 5 teams. The 5 teams on stage tonight have a chance at being awarded up to $10,000 in funding. Dreams will come true tonight. We would like to especially welcome our special guests, Camille Clay, Senior Director of College and Career Transition Programs for LISD, Jamie Everett, Coordinator of Career Development for LISD, Charlie Little, Principal of Vandegrift High School, and Mitzi Powell, Career Development Coordinator for LISD. At this time, we would like to thank the Leander ISD Board of Trustees. They encourage innovative educational programs like Incubator and provide the construction of facilities and technology needed to make these innovative programs successful. Let's get this started. First, I would like to introduce the judges who will be deciding our winning teams tonight. And later, you will learn a bit more about each of them. Kai Lam. Kristen Hewley. Brian Agnew. And Eric Green.
All right, my name is Zoe Emerson, and I'm going to be introducing you to the first team of the night. It is time to kick off the pitches for this evening. We all know the feeling of reaching for a sip of our favorite drink and realizing it spilled, or getting a brand new water bottle only to realize that it doesn't even fit in our car cup holder. Imagine a world where you had the freedom to fit any drink inside of your car cup holder. Here to make that world a reality, it's Cup Fitly. Are you ready for it?
Hello, good evening community members and judges. We are Cup Fitly and we are an all-woman run team, including our mentor, Mrs. Frierson. I'm Via, the CEO.
I'm Kyla, the CDO.
I'm Briley, CFO.
And I'm Vaishali, the CMO. So the problem that we're trying to solve is that the existing car cup holder doesn't fit a large variety of drinks. Rather than explain why this can be really annoying, inconvenient, and dangerous, we'd rather show you this problem instead.
Thank you.
tilted stage. Does your drink not fit into your car cup holder and cause an inconvenience every day? Now introducing Cup Fitly, an adjustable car cup holder that spins to fit large water bottles and small energy drinks.
You know what could just really change my life? A Cup Fitly.
I love Cup Fitly because it fits all of my energy drinks.
I love how the bottom of the cup holder can move so it doesn't hit the center of my console.
I like how the Cup Fitly will solve one of my problems that I have because my Hydro Flask currently does not fit in my cup holder.
We love Cup Fitly.
So, allow me to introduce you to the evolution of our product. At the beginning of the semester, we went from a piece of sketch into a prototype with a paper towel roll with foams on top of it. Then we move on to multiple 3D files, and finally, you're seeing the prototype right in front of you.
Okay, so I want to tell you exactly how our product works, but I want to first show you what our MVP product was and how far we've come. This is what we call our skeleton prototype. You can clearly see it's very bulky and angular and not as appealing looking. So now I want to show you what we're working with now, which is clearly much more sleek and thinner, and it works a lot better. So how it works is you move the outer edge to vary the diameter to fit smaller and larger drinks. And then that's not the only cool feature. When it's rattled, it also locks in place, so it's only going to move when you turn this. And the bottom is also detachable, so it's a compartment for valuables or like coins or anything you like to put on there. And then it also moves to the side, because we had customers feedback saying like, oh, what if it hits my console? So we wanted to be able to move it to meet the customer's needs. And then our bonus feature is that it has our little logo on the bottom. And then in the package, it'll come with a magnet on the bottom and a magnet that's loose to fit in your cup holder so it secures it to the car cup holder.
So when we look at the features of our product, we can see three main features. First, it's eco-friendly as it's a one-time purchase, and it's also, we have recyclable packaging. It's also adjustable. As Bradley said before, we have a rotating diameter to fit large and small energy drinks. And then finally, it's convenient because you don't want to have to worry about driving while your car, while your water bottle is rolling around on the floor while you're trying to focus on driving. So next, we have social media marketing, and this is how we've been marketing so far and how we also plan to market in the future. We've been using Instagram to advertise our product as well as influence our followers to come to the incubator lab themselves to come try out our product.
In addition to social media, our website is also a very important platform for us to communicate and advertise for our product. So we have also included an About Us page, which included a small description of us as a business. Then finally, on the About Us page, we have allowed a potential business partners and consumer to contact directly with us.
Okay, so as Vaishali talked about before, we did hold a focus group, and it was really helpful because we came in with a prototype that was much thinner because we were overcompensating for our bulky MVP prototype. So when we went in, we got a lot of feedback saying that the walls looked too thin and that it didn't look sturdy enough. So in the short amount of time, we were actually able to contact back the person that made it, make the walls thicker, and make it a lot sturdier to meet their needs and our own. So that was like a little word from our early adopters, but I want to show you a short word from our target market.
Hi, I am a full-time mom raising two kids, and I'm very active. I always carry a water bottle with me, but unfortunately, they often don't fit in my cup holder.
Oh man, my drink doesn't fit in the cup holder. A Cup Fitly would be really great for this.
I'm just telling you, I think this is the best invention ever.
This chart embodies our target market of car cup holders with the total value of $25 billion.
Okay, so as we've continuously talked about, we're an environmental business and we want our product to be sustainable. So the transaction base is going to be a one-time purchase. And then as of right now, our cost of goods sold is $9.30 with all things included. And we're sticking to our unit price, so we're going to be selling it at $25. Okay, so this is the big ask. We are asking for $5,000, which we know is a lot, but we're going to tell you exactly where the money's going. So first, with a few initial costs, would be our LLC. And then a more advanced, easy-to-use website for our customers. That's why the price is a little higher. And then, of course, printing our prototypes and then packaging, which would be our cardboard boxes and stickers.
And then the most thing that's going from our prize is going to be our own 3D printer, which we is a necessity to us because we'd like to have our products at a quicker and more accessible pace, as well as being able to customize it ourselves.
So next, for spreading the word, we'd reach out to our early communities first, and this includes the communities we're currently involved in, such as choir and band. Then to further spread the word, we'd reach out to large corporations. For example, we already reached out to Bucky's, and we called them and told them about our product. They let us know that they were really interested, and so they sent us a shipping label so that we can send them our product. And we're going to send them our product as soon as possible, and if they really like it, we can start selling there. We're also waiting to hear back from 7-Eleven and Carvana.
So finally, our plan to success. How are we going to achieve everything that we told you we're going to do? So of course, we want to use the money tonight to order everything that we need and print our first 150 products. Once we have revenue from that, we'll be able to get our patent. And we're already in contact with a patent person and lawyer. And we want to get their advice before we ship off our prototype to any big companies. But once we do, we can use the manufacturers that we've been working with over the past couple of months. And we can get our product in stores. Thank you so much for the opportunity to pitch in front of you tonight. Any questions?
You want me to go? I think, first of all, you guys did a tremendous job. I've mentioned this multiple times. From where you came from with the little white skeleton prototype to where you are today, that's really impressive in the short amount of time. And the fact that you've got, you know, Bucky's sending you a box to put it in and send it off and, you know, get them to take a look at it, that's impressive. I mean, I don't even know if I could do that. So I congratulate you on that. I mean, regardless of what happens tonight, you guys did a fantastic job. You put a lot of effort into this. And this was your idea from the beginning, too. So you guys were all in. Initially, and I love it. I guess my question that I have, and we kind of talked about some of this stuff last week when we were doing the initial, questions. The one thing that I did have is when you get the printer, or first of all, how long would it take to get this printer? Are these easily attainable? Do you have to order them special from somewhere? Because it seems like a pretty powerful piece of equipment. Is that something you can go down to where and get? Where do you get it from? All right, so you guys are going to order it on Amazon. Okay, so that takes care of that. And then you're going to do 150. What was where did you come up with that number? I don't think did you guys talk about that last week? Or I don't remember hearing the 150 was the initial rollout of products. Where did you come up with that number? What's the reason behind that number? Maybe if you guys can sort of help me understand.
Yeah, so we also took into consideration how much it would cost for us to get a patent, which I believe was about... $1,500. And so we want to make sure that we make that amount of money and more so that we have some extra money to put into anything else we need. So that's why we settled on the 150. And it was also kind of what worked with our budget and everything else that we factored into our costs.
So as far as the patent goes, how long will that take you to get? And how much, you said $1,500 to do the patent? How long does that normally take? Have you researched it?
We haven't looked into it too much yet. We are in contact with a patent person, but we want to make sure that they're okay with us sending our prototype to Bucky's and making sure that they don't steal the idea. So I think it would depend on that how much time it's going to take.
Okay. Yeah. And I know we did talk about that last week. Like, I love Bucky's. I'm not saying they'd steal the idea, but geez, look at what they have in there. They have literally everything you can imagine. So why not one of those? But anyway, I'm a customer. I'll buy one. So good job, ladies.
Thank you so much.
That was just one of the five teams you will see pitching tonight. You are all in for an exciting evening. Just a quick reminder, all teams are made up of juniors and seniors in high school. How many of you could have seen yourself doing this while in high school? Every year, our top team earns a submission for national pitch with Uncharted Learning. The last 3 years, our team has advanced as a finalist out of 200 schools. We want to take a moment to recognize them for their hard work and dedication. In 2020, Indus Naturals finished in the top 5. In 2021, Plain of Thought finished in the top 8. And last year, Slap Daddy finished in the top 12. Teams that pitch on stage tonight have earned a spot in next year's Accelerator EDU class. They will continue to develop their idea, form their LLC, and launch their business. As mentioned earlier, we're all part of Accelerator this school year. It has been a really fun year, and our teams have all accomplished such amazing things. Between pitches, we'll be showing what each of our 5 LLCs have been up to this year in Accelerator. We will start off the Excel videos and show you what Nordic Fresh has been up to this year.
Hi, I'm Lucas Ronigan, and I'm the CMO of Nordic Fresh.
I'm James Oring, and I am the Sales Director of Nordic Fresh.
I'm Drew Vora, and I'm the CEO of Nordic Fresh.
Hi, my name is Cooper Nelson, and I'm the CFO of Nordic Fresh.
Nordic Fresh is an organic, all-natural stain remover that removes stains better than our competing brands.
Nordic Fresh is derived from a Scandinavian recipe.
Nordic Fresh has done several things to further our business this year.
First thing Nordic Fresh has done is increased our web presence. With the updated website and an ability to pre-order, we have improved the customer experience.
Nordic Fresh also hosted a major outreach event in which we spread our product to a bunch of potential customers, such as Dylan Bullock.
It was a great time, and they even helped me expand my own business.
A huge thank you to all the people who have helped us along the way, especially last year, Mr. Agnew, Mr. Young, and Julian Young.
And a special thank you to Ms. Lucas and Ms. Mathis.
And thank you to everyone else who's followed the Nordic Fresh journey.
What a great video. We would like to thank the Leaf Education Foundation for their continued support of Incubator EDU. Their donations are used to build prototypes and help fund the teams you see tonight. Let's give a hand for Leaf.
All right, now who's ready for the next pitch? Partying hard and keeping guard, we have K9, who created a product to ensure safety of your loved ones.
Would you feel safe attending a party alone?
No.
No.
No. No.
Not at all.
Okay. Do you personally know a person who has experienced getting their drink spiked with a controlled substance?
Yes, me.
No.
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 Yeah, dude, I watched this frat guy put a capsule in my drink, and then my drink started to fizz, and I was like, I just threw it out, and I was like, I'm leaving this party.
Yeah.
As you heard in that interview that we collected ourselves when we went to UT, this is an alarming problem that's in college campuses, that problem being drink spiking. This is our company, K9, and we've sought out to fight against this problem. I'm Ari.
I'm Catherine.
I'm Cole.
I'm Ethan.
I'm Jack.
And we are K9. Our company was founded on the principle that we believe everyone deserves to come home safe. Regardless of where they went, they deserve to come home.
Unfortunately, someone very close to me did not get the opportunity to come home safe. As you can see in this photo, I'm hugging my best friend, and she gave me the opportunity to share this very private and alarming story. One summer night, I got the call when she was in Florida and I was in Texas that her drink had been spiked. I felt hopeless, and I didn't know what to do. So I shared this story with the team, and it turns out I was not the only one who had a similar experience with a loved one. So we came up with the goal of keeping our loved ones safe, and while doing that, helping fight against drink spiking and lacing.
But this isn't just down to our personal stories. 1 in 13 college students in the U.S. end up having their drink spiked, and 52% of victims of drink spiking are college students. This is extremely alarming because they are underrepresented in the solutions market as well.
This isn't just a woman's issue, it's an everybody's issue. And what I mean by this is every 1 in 5 victims are actually men who get their drinks spiked.
It turns out that 83% of women are spiked through alcohol, and 64% of male are spiked through alcohol. Some of the most common substances that are used in these drink spiking attacks are prescription drugs such as Rohypnol, Xanax, and Valium, and illicit drugs such as GHB, ketamine, and LSD.
Knowing the facts, we sought out to create the perfect solution for young adults such as ourselves. Knowing something that we always keep on us is our keys, we sought out to make a trendy keychain that young adults like ourselves would buy, and something that can easily be put on someone's key, and no one would bat an eye if they saw it hanging there. Our idea was a product that features a pen-like design that has paper within it that, once dipped inside a drink, changes colors once it contaminated with an illicit substance. After use, it can be torn off so that you're keeping it sanitary, discreet, and effective. So it's multi-use and can test multiple drinks at once or the same drink multiple times.
In order to create this high-quality product, we started out on paper in order to get an idea of what we wanted our product to look like. Then we moved to 3D modeling and 3D printing in order to create a real-life variant that we were able to test and develop for the next few months.
Our unique value proposition is making forensic-grade drug testing accessible to the everyday person, something that everyone can have at the touch of their fingertips. But this was just an idea when we presented our MVP pitches early in the year. We heard a lot of things. An idea like this could be revolutionary, but we mostly heard that this was something a bunch of high schoolers could not pull off. And we're here today to tell you that we did, in fact, pull this off.
Using our new prototype, we were able to travel to UT Austin, where we created one of our many interviews. Hinting on this, we really wanted to use this interview. It was different than the rest because we wanted to use this to post on social media to create a market presence.
And inside this interview, we found out that 1 in every 10 students actually had their drink spiked. And 5 out of the 10 students knew somebody who had their drink spiked. That's a lot like the research that we did in the beginning of the year.
Like I said before, we wanted to use this new information that we had found out to create a social media presence. And we actually posted one of the interviews on TikTok, and we almost got 1,000 likes. And we posted the same on Instagram Reels, where we were able to get almost 1,000 views. We really want to encourage young adults that you can keep guard while partying hard.
And for the part that you've all been waiting for, we have developed fully functioning keychains.
In order to develop these keychains, over the past few months, we have changed to resin 3D printing in order to create a durable and high-quality product while also changing the design, allowing our keychains to become more user-friendly straight out of the box.
The science behind this is we reached out to a manufacturer in a lab that creates this thing called lateral flow assays, which are small paper strip-like things that look for certain compounds in a substance. They're typically bought by companies that work to create machinery that examines urine to regularly look for certain substances. This manufacturer provided us with a bulk order of benzodiazepine compound searching lateral flow assays. With that, we were able to design our keychain around these strips, and we're happy to tell you that our strips and our keychains can test for a wide variety of different drugs. Xanax, Rohypnol, Valium being some of the major ones that we know are used in drink spiking, and a variety of different others.
Don't believe us? Watch the video. As you can see in the video, I'm placing a pill of Xanax into one of the H2O cups. I also decided to take the strip out of the K9 to represent that we were not using false information. As you can see, two small lines start to appear. This means that the drink has tested negative for spiking. Again, I'm taking a blank strip, placing it into the K9. But this time, I'm testing for Xanax. I dip it into the water with the Xanax. And slowly over time, you'll see that one line appears, which means it is positive for drink spiking.
We did multiple tests to make sure that this wasn't just a lucky shot from our keychain. Each try, trying four times.
You're probably wondering what an amazing product like this would cost. And all the research we've done. Our cost of goods is $134, while our unit price we want to sell it at is $14.99, which comes with a K9 and 5 strips. Our equal gross margin is $13.65, and then that makes our percentage 91.06.
Compared to our competition, the K9 is a lot more practical. It's fairly discreet as well, and it's multiple use. Compared to looking at some of our competition, the strips from Test My Drink can only test for two different drugs, and the nightcap is essentially a paid version of putting your hand over a drink and cannot test at all to see if there's anything in your drink.
So we're asking for $5,000 for you to help us in this fight against drink spiking and help us mass produce the K9. And put it in stores and bars. The thing is, a product like this could save a bunch of lives, and if we can save just one person from having this happen to them, our goal is complete. With this, if you've noticed, our brand is K9, and this product is K9. Because to us, this business is so much bigger than just Vandegrift High School. We see this being a lot larger, and we wanted to give ourselves the freedom to expand different horizons with making portable drug testing something that everyone can have in their pocket, or on their keys. We drafted out a bunch of different ways for us to build a solid foundation for ourselves, which includes starting an LLC, and we are in the process of getting provisional patents, so that would give us 1 year of utility rights over this idea of having portable drug testing for college students.
Along with that, we are looking for $400 to get started with aluminum manufacturing to make sure we have a high-end and durable version of our product, along with looking for $330 to start buying a 3D printer so we can start making products and getting them out to the market. The last thing that we need is $200 for packaging and shipping out products, which includes labels, packaging, and bubble mailers.
And then going on with marketing, we have $250 for our logo and brand, $100 for our email organizations, accounting plans, we have $300, and then for market and advertising, we have $800.
The rest of the money will be going towards mass producing our product and getting as many out there, as we believe that this is something that every student can benefit from having.
Thank you so much.
I just want to start by saying wonderful job. I'm so impressed with your product and with your passion for this. I love the video integration in your pitch as well. I have a couple questions for you. One being the money that you put in there for a logo. Is that a K9 logo or is that to revamp the K9 logo?
Another thing that we had in mind is also getting our own website domain and all kinds of branding stuff made towards our company, because that will give it a really solid foundation, especially towards marketing towards young adults, because young adults notice that kind of thing.
Great. Thank you for that explanation. And then one thing we discussed after your pitch last week that we're unsure if we asked, how long does it actually take once you put the strip in the drink to see the lines?
Last time that we timed it, it took exactly 45 seconds.
Thank you.
I see the value in you moving from a protective approach of putting a coaster on top of a drink to now, whether that worked or not, you have further proof. And I can see a potential for it being a deterrent with your brand being known. If you have other people see that, less likely to even attempt, right? So I celebrate you for that, with your brand being known. The question I have for you is, as a next step for checking the viability of those strips, keys get tossed around, right? Thrown in purses, stuffed in pockets, run into things. And then I was also thinking about like humidity or rain. Could you just speak a little bit to that in terms of the protection integrity of the strips in there?
So I'll add on just like from my personal anecdote, I've had this on my keys for quite a while. It's held up pretty well, and we have recently used it to test some more. And so far, the strips have held up. That's why one of the biggest things that we're looking towards is getting aluminum manufacturing on the way, because aluminum is a lighter material and it's a lot more durable. Jack can speak more towards that because he's our guy with aluminum.
Yes, so the aluminum, working towards that, it'll be more in sealed and closed, allowing us to have a better protection around the strips. And our design is based off of a sealed design, so it is very unlikely that you're going to be able to get bacteria inside of the device.
First of all, good job, guys. This is impressive. And I've already told you, like, this is a huge need. And I'm happy to hear that high school kids are going to turn it around and make it happen, because it appears that there's a lot of companies that try this and they can't get it off the ground. I don't know why. I feel like simplicity, which is what you guys have done, might actually be the answer. The question, though, that I have is, how are you going to sell it? Online, or are you trying to get it in to the anti-drug stores, or where are those?
So what we want to do is kind of incorporate these like maybe stands into bars or clubs, you know, so we could start selling from there, or even just give them away.
Okay.
So the exposure is out.
But if we were to say, here's $5,000, how quick can you turn it around? How quick can you start selling? And what would be the first place that you would try to start selling?
Well, our most viable option right now is selling in bars, particularly because this is a big need, and most bar owners know that this kind of a thing is a huge liability for them. So our first instinct would be to reach out towards them once we have our finalized prototypes made, and then, of course, online retail would definitely be an option for us to target our younger markets, like, for instance, like Instagram shops and having our own website.
So the reason I ask is because there's not even a dollar amount set for the website. It just says whatever's left over. I think you got to really put a lot of, unless I'm missing it, I'm kind of looking from the side here. So unless I'm missing it, you need to put probably quite a bit of weight into the website. I think that's probably going to be the easiest way to sell. You know, going into bars and things, that's not going to be as easy. And I don't know where the bars would put it. I think it's a great idea, though. I mean, I think you should have some sort of face-to-face outreach that you're doing, but the website's going to be priority. So I think you're going to need to maybe adjust some of the dollar amounts on a few of those categories first. And maybe the aluminum is not necessary right now. Just get it out, like, you know, version 1.0, and then aluminum's 2.0.
And then real quick, you already have a proof of concept with this for alarms, whistles that are given to first year students in colleges. So you talk to those folks, connect with them, and you have a flow of putting a batch sale out there. Yeah.
This is your marketing guy right here. He just gave you the best idea ever. Like, that would be amazing to be able to take that to the campuses and they could hand it out, you know, to freshmen who are going through orientation or something. I don't know. Good job, guys.
Thank you so much, everybody.
I'd now like to reintroduce two of our four judges who will be deciding our winning teams tonight. Brian Agnew has over 27 years of business experience, including being an entrepreneur for the last 14 years. He founded Supero Healthcare Solutions in 2009 and sold the company to Payer Health / Osceola Capital Management in an asset deal in August of 2022. He's currently taking some time off before jumping back into the game and is looking to acquire some businesses, as well as providing consulting and mentoring services to help other entrepreneurs grow and strengthen their businesses. He's been a coach and mentor in the VHS Incubator Program since its inception 5 years ago. Brian is married to Stacy and have two kids, Braden and Alexa. We also have Mr. Eric Green. He has been engaged with students in learning since 2002 on questions related to communication. In particular, his work focuses on conflict resolution, relationship development, family interactions, authentic speaking, group dynamics, and reclaimed conversation in an era of distraction. He has a PhD in interpersonal communications from the University of Texas and has served as a professor of communications at Concordia University, Texas since 2011. He's a communications coach with the McCombs School of Business at the University of Texas and works on special projects with Quantified Communications, an Austin-based firm that helps people improve their communications through data and behavioral analytics. Now let's continue with our pitches. Are you guys having fun? The fastest growing sport in the world just got even faster. They're destroying the barriers that prevent you from playing whenever you want, driving the hoop to you. The only basketball hoop where you can play anywhere and everywhere. It's Porta Hoop. Group team. That keeps the problem. There we go. All right. So the problem is with other sports like soccer, football, and baseball, those are all easily portable. You can always just go out to the park and play them. But when it comes to basketball, you need a court and you need a hoop, and those aren't always accessible to everyone. The most portable way to play basketball is with the ones in your driveway, but those ones are a pain in the butt to set up. They're not always reliable, and the HOA half the time doesn't even allow them in your driveway. So this creates a major problem with accessibility in the sport of basketball.
This allows us to introduce our product.
It's easily expandable and can go all the way up to regulation height from about 4 feet tall. And it can be played anywhere you can take your car, whether it's a lake, a park, or even a random parking lot. It's also incredibly sturdy and safe and can even be dunked on.
Hey!
And everyone of all ages loves the Porta Hoop.
Even the children.
And it's easily to collapse in just a couple of seconds. Then you can drive off or throw it in the back of any trunk or trunk bed.
It fits into most different SUVs, like an Outback, or it can be as big as a truck. And then an endorsement from an NBA legend.
I love Porta Hoop. It's my favorite incubator invention I have ever seen. Shout out to Xavier, Cody, Seb, and Henry.
Thank you, AI LeBron. And this is what's so unique about Porta Hoop. It's the only truly portable basketball hoop on the market. It has no direct competitors or competition, and it's the only truly portable basketball hoop.
Here are some of the crucial innovations that allowed the Porta Hoop to be so revolutionary. We have an adjustable angle that can move up to 270 degrees that allows the Porta Hoop to be folded down for portability, and it can also be customized during play. At the base of the Porta Hoop, we have a telescopic ladder which can hold up to 330 pounds, which allows the Porta Hoop to be very sturdy and very portable. These functions in conjunction with each other allow the Porta Hoop to be very customizable so that anyone can play, from kids to adults. These features also allow the Porta Hoop to be very portable, as it can go from full regulation height to being able to collapse down to a trunk or truck bed.
Additionally, on top of the benefits of Porta Hoop, it's also extremely safe. Whether you drive a car or a truck, the Porta Hoop is only 55 pounds and is supported by any class tow hitch from class 1 all the way to class 4.
And then additional opportunities that come with the Porta Hoop that we can profit off of externally, whether it's a hail blanket, a softer ball, or a net that can protect your car from possible air balls. You know, not everyone's the greatest shooter sometimes. And then with branding, being able to stick like a logo of like Texas or A&M or Vandegrift, Go Vipers, being able to stick that on the backboard for tailgate lovers. So that's different external ways to profit off the Porta Hoop. So.
Our journey so far has been quite a long one. We started back in the fall with a crazy idea that we wanted to make a reality. We were able to make a 3D model that we brought to the MVP pitch where we presented to judges and earned enough money to build our first prototype. Like how many great businesses start, we built our first prototype in a garage of one of my mountain bike coaches, who luckily had a lot of welding material and machines to help us build our first prototype. And our first prototype was actually quite a success, and we can put it on many SUVs and trucks successfully and play a game of basketball. Now we have a website built, and we can market and sell from social media and the website.
Our market potential is huge. About $5.8 billion went into sports and outdoor games in 2021. And that was a 41% growth from 2019, and it is a continuously growing market.
Our total addressable market we value at $840 million. This is quite a large number. It is all the people ages 25 to 44 years old who have a personal income of over $100K per year. And this is also people who tailgate. And our serviceable addressable market is $278 million based off of those people that have more interest in basketball. The cost of our Porta Hoop to build for the masses we expect to be $320 because the labor and the shipping will be very expensive. Our prototype was only $250, but we didn't have to pay for labor or shipping for that.
This leads me into other tailgate accessories that are also made out of steel. Other products like bike racks, novelty accessories like grills or hammocks, and even storage compartments all are in the mid-$100 range, which allows Porta Hoop to appeal to that larger, more luxurious market, which allows us to price Porta Hoop at about $599. Other basketball hoops on the market, plasticky, cheaper ones, can range from about $150 to $300, whereas heavy metal, acrylic, steel hoops that are extremely customizable and durable can range from about $500 to $2,000, which, when you put Porta Hoop at $699 or $599, it's very competitive and is a slam dunk of a price. This, okay, yeah, which is why we're asking for $5,000 to allow us to continue the Portage journey.
We would spend these $5,000 for first to start an LLC for our business, to get a provisional patent to protect our idea in the short term, a trademark to protect our brand and our cool idea, and then we would spend the rest of the $4,000 for further research and development to make our product even more portable, easy to set up, easy to take down, and just a higher quality, more customizable product.
And then here are the next steps with going to the market. So we get the word out through social media and through our website and through those people, starting to create a pre-order list of possible pre-order buyers. And then once we've gotten that done, we'd like to finalize the design. This prototype does work. It just isn't able to be mass produced yet because these are all off-the-shelf items that we welded together in a freaking garage. So we'd like to finalize a design that is easily to be mass produced and go into manufacturing production. And then that's when we start to manufacture and start to sell Porta Hoop across the country. So with that being said, thank you very much.
Thank you.
I always have questions. Y'all know I love this. Like this is what being an entrepreneur is all about. You come up with the idea, you find somebody who's got a freaking welding kit at their house through mountain biking together. I mean, it's like that's the cool story behind this, and it just shows you like anybody can do whatever they put their mind to. So what I want to know though is, I mean, it's awesome, and that works. And I know we're talking about mass production, and that gets really, really expensive. It's probably going to, you know, $4,000 is probably not going to get there in terms of what you really need to do something miraculous with this product. So with the $4,000, I know that's going to be the research and development and type of stuff. I mean, this sort of seems like a multi-stage type business where you've got the proof of concept. I mean, you've got video of that. So the question I have though is, how hard is it going to be to really get a true prototype that you can literally go and, you know, maybe meet with somebody at Target or Academy or Dick's, you know, somewhere to get one of these bad boys in? Because I would assume that'd be like the best place to go. So what does that look like for you guys?
So as far as that goes, we're going to look to get a designer to help get us a really good design because it is expensive to create these prototypes. This is our first prototype, and it works pretty darn well. So we're looking to hopefully create only one more design to conserve as much money as possible. And then as far as further funding, that's what Accelerator is going to be all about. We're going to be further advancing into other pitches across the country, across Texas, hoping to get more funding from other pitches that are also going to help fund our product through the future. So we'd like to create maybe only one more finalized product that we can build so that we can conserve money, and then with the remaining money after we've created one extra prototype, then we use that remaining money to create as many as we can and to sell as many as we can.
What would you replace?
As far as replacements go, we're thinking about going to one stationary pole instead of two and just making it thicker so that's easier collapsible. We like the rim to be able to be foldable or detachable, and it can be lighter. This is 55 pounds. It's not crazy heavy, but you'd be surprised the rim actually does hold a lot of weight. So we like for it to be foldable or detachable. It'd be crazy for the portability aspect. And it's just the fact that all of this is off-the-shelf things. Like being able to just create one like fluid design of it. But yeah, the main things are going to be the poles and the rim.
I think you guys might want to give your buddy who came off the bench to hold your prototype up a
Thank
shout
you,
out, right?
James O-ring for you.
Hey, big shout out to James. Yeah, no, like backstage, we were like, oh, who's going to hold up our thing? Because, I mean, I mean, it's just kind of awkward with the tow hitch. And so James is a trooper. He was like, hey, I'll hold it for y'all. And so we're forever thankful. You chilling? Okay, all right. All right, any more questions? Oh, good. Awesome. All right.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you for allowing us to pitch in front of y'all. Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Oh, shoot.
Oh, yeah.
Someone go home.
You killed the entrance.
Yeah, appreciate that.
Our teams are not making it an easy decision for our judges. Judges, how are y'all feeling? Let's take a moment to introduce our final two judges, Christian Hughley. Christian Hughley has served as an executive leader for over a decade at multiple nonprofit organizations. Her community engagement and national emergency assistance programs, relationship development, and marketing strategies have increased each nonprofit's annual revenue, making it possible to better serve their communities. She's developing 10 House Strategies, a strategic partnership to enhance nonprofits, workplace culture, sustainability, and impact. She serves on the Cedar Park Library Foundation's Capital Campaign Committee and the Leander Chamber of Commerce Board of Directors. Kristen earned a master's degree of business administration from Tarleton State University and a Bachelor of Arts in Communication and Public Relations from Baylor University. She enjoys going on adventures with her husband and creating award-winning short films together as 10 House Productions. Kai Lam. Kai's professional journey began with the opening of various Las Vegas casinos after graduating from the University of Nevada, Reno. In 1999, he ventured into entrepreneurship by launching a web design and hosting company, which he still operates with his partner. In 2006, after working at a major Wall Street brokerage, he founded Solaris Private Wealth Management, a fee-only registered investment advisor. Apart from his successful for-profit ventures, Kai has also founded three 501c nonprofit organizations. These initiatives have made a significant impact in supporting education, women, and children initiatives, and military veterans, distributing over $2.7 million. Kai has been happily married to Michelle for 29 years, and they are proud parents to two daughters, Jordan, VHS class of 2019, UT class of 2023, and Baylor Law class of 2026, and Reagan, VHS class of 2023, and Florida Institute of Technology class of 2027. While it looks competitive in incubator, someone else says, especially tonight, we have learned that we need each other to be successful entrepreneurs. This especially applies to our year in Accelerator. Let's take a look at what our friends in Surprise Shoddy have been up to this year.
Hi, my name is Mayan Applicator, and I am the CEO of Surprise Shoddy.
And I'm Anushka, I'm the CMO of Surprise Shoddy.
We created Surprise Shoddy last year as a solution for parents who need a convenient gift for their college students.
Some of the successes we've had this year have to do with our marketing strategies and our campaigns. Not only have we been able to reach parents on Facebook and Instagram, we've also been able to reach college students, and it's given us the ability to expand our product to being something not only parents can buy for their students, but also students can buy for their friends who go to other colleges.
The main things we did this year was redesign our box. By doing so, we included products from small businesses, which include naturally made soaps and college posters. And by doing this, we increased the value of our box and we made it more special and customizable for our consumers.
We've had an amazing year so far. We've learned and we've grown so much, and we are looking forward to using the teachings from the Accelerator and Incubator program in future endeavors.
We want to give a huge thank you to our mentor, Ms. Barbara, for guiding us throughout the past 2 years.
We also want to thank Ms. Mathis and Ms. Lucas for everything they've taught us for the past 2 years. This program truly would not be the same without them. Thank you!
We are very thankful for all our volunteers and our teams. Our teams could not accomplish what we have without their support. We want to take this opportunity to thank all the wonderful volunteers this school year. If you have volunteered as a mentor, coach, helped us prepare for pitches, or judged, please stand up. Thank you all. You are what makes this program amazing. Audience members, you may be wondering how you can get involved in this amazing program. Incubator only works when it has the support of the community. There are a number of ways to volunteer your time and or money to this program. Volunteer to work with these amazing kids as a coach or a mentor. This link will take you to a Google form to fill out. The second way is donating. All money awarded tonight was donated. Funds donated to the program go directly to the students. If you're interested in donating to help our student teams pursue their business ideas, there's an option for donations on this link. Third way is to make a deal with a team to help them move forward into the second year of this program, Accelerator, next fall. All our teams are in search of funding, so if you see a team on stage tonight or earlier in the lobby that you want to fund, please let us know.
Just a reminder that up to $10,000 will be awarded tonight. Funded teams will continue with the program next school year, so if there's an idea that you see that you want to see in the marketplace that is not pitching on the stage tonight, consider funding them. And now we're going to continue with our fourth pitch of the night. Exuberance is a dynamic company dedicated to revolutionizing the way people boost their energy levels. They offer a new way to get energized without the crash and jitters often associated with traditional caffeine sources. With Exuberance, customers can enjoy a sustained and steady energy boost to power them through their day.
Good evening, judges. I'm Sam Gazaris, and I'm the CMO.
My name is Arjun Dewagan, and I'm the CTO.
My name is Aryan Sunder, and I'm the COO.
And my name is Zachary Butler, and I'm the CEO of our company.
Wait, where's Grant?
Where's our CSR? Wait. This is the most important pitch all year.
Grant, what are you doing?
Dude,
you look tired, man. You need some Exuberance?
I got you, fam.
I got you.
Woo! That's what I need, baby. My name's Grant Stevenson, and I'm the CSR. And together, us five make up Exuberance. Let's be honest, guys. We've all had a day where we couldn't get out of bed, much less have a full productive day at work. And our team is no different. Aryan spends upwards of 20 hours a week for a sport on top of school. But that starts to complicate things. He's exhausted in the morning, and he has trouble staying awake in school. And that hinders his performance in school. He's tried using coffee, but it's not exactly the best for him because he starts to have trouble making it in the morning because he's exhausted. He has trouble buying it when he's going because it's so expensive. And it's not even healthy for him. Worst of all, it doesn't give the energy he needs to last all day and leaves him struggling. This isn't a problem that just pertains to this young athlete. It pertains to everyone, from young to old, from work to daily activities to spending time with your loved ones. This is a problem everyone has. And so that's why, together, we did what everyone wanted, a solution. If you care about your well-being and you care about having a full, productive day at work, you're going to want to hear about our company, Exuberance. We've created a slow-release caffeinated gummy that gives you the energy to get you going and keep you going all day long. Using our organic recipe, we give customers what they want, when they want, and a tasty, affordable, healthy alternative to coffee. Time for some energy. Time for some Exuberance. And if anyone wants some energy, make some noise!
Yeah!
That's what I'm talking about.
So over time, we've done research on different companies that follow a similar product as us. So as you can see, none of the companies we researched offer slow release in their recipe. I repeat, none of them offer the slow release caffeine in their recipe. Now, if we go to the recipe being organic, only one recipe is completely organic, and that's Punch's gummies. Now, compared to the caffeine per package, each is about, the Cliff Blocks was about 25 milligrams of caffeine being the lowest. And Profix gummies and Punch gummies were only about 100 milligrams of caffeine. Now, compared to us as Zubrins, we offer slow-release caffeine in our recipe. Our recipe is completely organic and natural. And we also offer the most caffeine at 200 milligrams. Now, you might be asking, why so much coffee in just six gummies? Well, we did the research, and the average American consumes about 200 milligrams of caffeine per day, or two cups of coffee, which each cup of coffee being about 100 milligrams of caffeine. So we wanted to make sure that Americans get the energy that they need without any sacrifices.
So in addition to looking at who our competitors were, we did a bit of research to see what our total market would be. So what we found was that there's $90.2 billion in the total U.S. caffeine industry. Now, if we get rid of coffee, we find that there's $39 billion to be made. Now, narrowing that down even further to just our local Texas area, we find that there's $1.2 billion to be made. Now, you might have been wondering, what is that slow-release caffeine that Sam was talking about earlier? Now, I'd like you to take a look at this graph, and you'd see that one that spikes up and then goes straight down, that dotted line, that is your regular caffeine. That's what you find in your coffee. You get that immediate spike, and then you crash. No energy after that. You're feeling tired throughout your day. Now, compare that to slow-release caffeine, where you get that gentle slope up, and then it gradually goes down. By getting 100 milligrams of slow-release and 100 milligrams of fast release, or your normal caffeine, you get that fast energy as soon as you get, as soon as you eat these gummies, with none of the crash.
As Arjun just said, we will, in our organic recipe, we will feature both types of this caffeine. In addition, we will use gelatin, water, sugar, agave syrup, citric acid, fruit purees, and fruit extracts. We currently have three flavors. One is experimental in blue raspberry. However, we feel that we have nearly perfected our strawberry and orange flavors.
We surveyed 40 people, and we had them try both of our flavors, strawberry and orange. We had them rate the taste, and the average rating for the strawberry was an 8.9 out of 10, and the average rating for orange was an 8.6 out of 10. Our feedback was to improve the texture of the gummy, and since then, we added more gelatin, which makes it firmer and more gummy-like.
One of the most important concerns we get is the FDA. So some questions we get are, how exactly are we going to legally sell our product and how will we get FDA approved? Well, some responses we have for that is, out of the 40 people we interviewed, none said that FDA approval was necessarily a purchase driver for our product. And secondly, we can also rent a licensed commercial kitchen to legally and safely sell our product. Next, since we're a supplement company instead of a food company, we have looser FDA regulations, which will help us get into the market of retail stores easier.
Speaking of retail stores, in the future, we see Zubrins as a product that can get into the shelves of major retailers such as GNC, HEB, and Target. In the past month, we've grown our Instagram to over 150 followers and our TikTok to over 46 followers. Right now, our main focus is finalizing our product and our packaging, but once we do that, we will create a website in order to generate sales, and we will use paid social media advertising in order to drive people to our website.
So, you might be wondering, what are we going to do after final pitch, after this pitch night? Well, the first thing that we plan to do is, with the money that we get, we will create an LLC so that we can be legally, formally, and professionally recognized as a company. Furthermore, we plan on perfecting our recipes. Our blue raspberry flavor is needs a bit of tweaking before we can perfect that and lock that down. Furthermore, we will rent a commercial kitchen, which Sam touched on, and we will use that to produce our gummies in a legal manner so that we can sell them. And we will sell them using our website, which, as it says, we will use to sell our product, and we will use our social media to make a cycle that grows and grows and helps our business expand.
Now tonight, what we're asking for. We are asking for $5,000. Why do we need $5,000, you may ask? Well, we need $300 for our LLC, $2,400 to rent a commercial kitchen space, $1,950 to purchase our raw goods and materials, and $350 for website development.
So judges, time for some energy. Time for some exuberance. Each of our team members will present you one with each box, which has our orange and strawberry flavor. However, it is late at night, and you've already tested our flavor, so you don't have to eat them today. However, we do advise them you eat them tomorrow, so you have an energized and productive day.
One more thing to add. You all may be wondering why we're dressed so informal. I'm dressed like a high schooler. Arian's dressed like a soccer player. Sam's dressed like a college student. Arjun's dressed like a businessman. And Grant, as you can see, is acting like a gym rat. And to answer that question, I actually want all the people on stage and in the audience to raise their hand if they've ever consumed caffeine. 1, 2, 3, 4, I can't count that high. So, we believe that our gummy has a universal appeal to all demographics that consume caffeine. So we're dressed as the different demographics because we don't believe that there's a specific type of person that we need to focus on. Thank you all for listening, and I hope you have a good evening. Do we have any questions?
I'm going to have one. First question, how many gummies did y'all have before this presentation?
Too many.
Okay. It's like a natural orange flavor, like an orange juice instead of a candy orange. It's so good. I lost my question. Go ahead.
Yeah, I can confirm strawberry's legit. It's good. I have tried it. So I will never get coffee out of my life. If coffee could be my third child, it probably would. I did try one of them last week, and I could tell the difference a little bit. It does work, no doubt. And I think you guys have done a good job. I think it's really interesting, the time release that you have. I think the question I got is, and we talked about the numbers. We don't have to really get into the weeds of the numbers. We already did a lot of that last week. So has anything changed since last week? You know, with the numbers and what you're proposing here. I just want to make sure, because I remember what we talked about last week. Has anything changed right here?
For here?
Yeah.
No, nothing has changed.
Okay. That's what I was wondering. So is it the Ghost Kitchen? Is that where you would go do this?
It's the Hudson Bend Commercial Kitchen.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Okay. That's only questions I have, but I love it, man. I think it's a good job. Show everybody let me show you. This is what they came up with. Just sort of a little packet. And how many's in here? Five? Six. Okay, six gummies. It's pretty cool.
It kicked in, and I remember my question. So any response from TikTok followers is my kind of first question. And the kind of follow-up question is, you have a great opportunity for education around time release, right? So I was thinking last time I heard your pitch about athletes, right? And athletes, long distance runners, swimmers, cyclists, kind of know how to plan what they're intaking to finish well. And you've got a totally new opportunity for athletics in a lot of ways. And I'm not sure if that's who your TikTok followers were or if there were other folks that were kind of giving you some feedback on this, but I'm just curious to hear response from folks.
So in our social media, we got a lot of great feedback, and most of them were people at our school, but obviously they play like many sports, soccer, track, they're banned, they do a lot of extracurriculars. And then in terms of the slow release, I mean, it is revolutionary. You know, no one else has this, and I feel like, you know, if we introduce this to the market, I mean, I feel like there's no like limit.
To add on to that, there's also a lot more factors besides sports that we like to consider. There's also that when I interviewed college students, they said that coffee was a big dent in their general like budget whenever they're in college. So this cheaper alternative would be something better than like the average price that I looked at when I did research was $3.65 for a cup of coffee. Now, going back to what I said about the research about the two cups of coffee, that's almost $8 in total. and we were planning the prices at about $3 to $4, which would be about half the cost of what coffee will be.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you so much.
Hey, y'all. Now we have a surprise for our wonderful mentors.
Hey, Sean. Thank you so much for being such an awesome mentor.
You definitely taught us a lot about the business world. Definitely taught us solidifying our choice in the future to do what I want.
And you were not just a mentor, but you were a great role model for us, and you were such an inspiration for our business. Thank you so much for helping us out through the entire year, and we're so glad we met you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for helping us with our planning.
And thank you all for your effort.
And thank you so much for taking your time to help us with our companies.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Taylor, Mr. Jacob, for everything you've done all year. We really appreciate all your hard work. We're so grateful. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr.
Well, we'd like to thank all our judges and mentors.
Thank you, Mr. Wellborn.
We want
to thank all of the amazing volunteers that have helped us through this process.
We are so grateful for your time.
You've truly made a difference in the growth of our company.
And we're especially thankful to our amazing mentor, Crystal. Thank you.
Thank you to everyone who's helped us this year, especially our amazing mentor, Mr. Raja Shekhar.
From all of us at Team Armadillo, we'd just like to say thank you very much for everything.
Hey, Ms. Foster. Hey. We just wanted to come on here and say thank you so much for everything that you've done for us.
Thank you. You've been the best. We have appreciated everything we've done.
Yeah, we definitely couldn't have done it without you.
We had so much fun with you as our mentor.
You know, we're a lot to handle.
Thank you for helping us this year as our mentor.
Thank you for being our mentor, Ms. Richtemeyer. We really appreciate your help.
You're the best mentor we could ever ask for.
Thank you for taking time out of your day to help us.
We appreciate you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Michael.
I know you're busy, but we appreciate you setting aside time for us.
Thank you so much for all of your help on our prototype and everything else along the way.
And lastly, thank you for being our greatest supporter and acknowledging our hard work.
Thank you, Dan.
Yeah,
thank you for all the help. Thank you,
Dan.
And support.
I love you, Dan.
Always helping us.
You to G.
Thank you, judges, for giving us feedback.
Thank you.
Made us
better. Couldn't have done it without
you. Much love.
Thanks for the money, too, or designating the money to us.
It's super cool that we have such a great turnout here for our incubator pitch night. And for some of you who may be unfamiliar with the program, let me share a few facts. Of the more than 200 high schools currently delivering this curriculum, the program at Vandegrift has one of the most successful launches in the Austin area. This year, 96 students formed 22 startups. Last week, all 22 of those teams pitched to our wonderful judges. Talking with the judges, they had a very difficult time narrowing it down to only 5 teams, and these students have put in a lot of hard work over the course of the school year. They've spent countless hours at school, on weekends, and even on holidays. Let's give all of the incubator students one more round of applause. Next, we're going to show you what our team Boreas has been up to this school year. Follow me, we're going to go through a whole year.
Hey guys, we're the cooler half of Boreas, and throughout this year we have done many things.
Such as creating our LLC, getting our EIN, and starting up our bank account as well.
We have also made more prototypes, and we're getting our blankets manufactured.
all, my name's Ivani and I'm the COO of Boreas. We just wanted to also extend some thank yous. First of all, to Ms. Leslie Wade for being a wonderful mentor. She always helps us out throughout whenever we need help. Additionally, thanks to both of the Aarons, Ms. Mathis and Ms. Lucas. They have both been so supportive and are always willing to help us out and give us a helping hand whenever we need. And lastly, we wanted to thank our blanket creation team, from our seamsters and seamstresses to anyone else who helped us go throughout the way to create our blanket prototype.
Hi, my name is Luke Ballingy and I'm the CEO of Boreas Blankets. And so we initially started with a small scale seamster, and he was doing a great job of going through alterations and getting us through our different prototypes so we knew what we wanted. But at a certain point, we needed to move to a larger scale manufacturer, and so we went to a different seamstress who specialized in making blankets more on a larger scale than initially. But despite all the fun that we had in the accelerator and incubator programs, we have unfortunately decided to not pursue Boreas Blankets any further, and I'll be studying aerospace engineering at University of Texas Austin. Hook over.
In the fall, I'll be going to San Diego State to study marine biology.
And I'll be going to Notre Dame to study business and run cross country and track.
And I'll be attending University of Texas at Austin to study finance. Hook 'em.
Thank you so much for such a wonderful year.
All right, time for the final pitch of the evening. All natural, healthy, and craveable, what more could you want in a snack? Here to bring you the ultimate snacking experience, it's Austin's first ever flavored microwave popcorn brand, Kapopcorn. Life is too short to eat boring snacks, so go get yourself some Kapopcorn. Hello? Hello, we're Kapopcorn, and we make all-natural flavored microwavable popcorn with flavors you crave. Sorry. Throw it in the microwave for 2 minutes and have the best snack of your life. No extra work required. I'm Vix Welborn, the product manager.
I'm Carly Jasinski, the CFO, and this is Crystal Towns, our mentor.
I'm Kendall Couch, and I'm in charge of social media and marketing.
And I'm Gabby Cadella, and I'm the CEO.
The problem with popcorn on the market today is that if you buy it pre-popped, it tends to go stale, and if you buy microwavable popcorn, it has unhealthy ingredients and limited flavors.
Our solution is that we use all natural ingredients, have unique flavors, and offer freshness due to the fact that you can pop it at your own home.
Our market size is
here, Carly. Here's our unique value proposition. In this chart, you can see Kapopcorn compared against three of our top competitors, Cornucopia, Austin Gourmet, and Pop Secret. Cornucopia and Austin Gourmet are two local companies that sell pre-popped flavored popcorn, and Pop Secret is a microwave popcorn company with a very limited flavor range. Our major advantage in the microwave popcorn market is that we have a wide variety of flavors, which really isn't seen anywhere else in the market. So far, we have our lemon and churro flavors finalized. We're working on our jalapeno flavor, and we have many more flavors to come.
Our market size is 15 billion quarts of popcorn are popped in the U.S. and 10.5 billion quarts of popcorn are popped in homes. Before the MVP pitch, we had tested a variety of different churro popcorn recipes, and once we were satisfied with one, we took it to focus groups during pit, as well as produced surveys for feedback and flavor recommendations.
Since our last pitch, we have finalized our churro popcorn recipe, as well as our lemon recipe. Throughout this time, we've been working on our new jalapeno recipe, sampling at Relay for Life, hosting focus groups, and working on packaging. Here's us sampling at Relay for Life. Relay for Life is an event that Vandegrift hosts each year to raise funds and awareness for cancer. While we were there, we gained insightful feedback from students, faculty, and volunteers. We saw this as a great way to connect with the community, sample our churro popcorn within a portion of our target market, and raise visibility for our brand.
For our flavor testing, we have completed testing on, or we finalized our churro and our lemon flavor, and we are currently working on our jalapeno flavor. To do that, we tried dehydrated jalapenos, which we found didn't give the volume or capsaicin that we needed. We want that kick. And then we tried infused oil with freeze-dried jalapenos. This was not up to our company's standard, so now we are working on, with a freeze-dried jalapeno powder and a bunch of spices to get to something that we can be proud of. Here's our packaging mock-up for our churro flavor. We plan to highlight our minimal and healthy ingredients. We also plan to use polyfluorocarbon-free packaging, and we have 6 units per box.
Here's our unit cost for our churro flavored popcorn. It came out to be 83 cents per unit, including ingredients and packaging. So for our future plans, as we've said before, we have our churro and lemon flavors finalized, and we're continuing to develop our jalapeno flavor. And in June, we have 2 sampling events set up, one at Vision Coffee in Barton Springs and another at the Contra Common Market in Bee Cave. After that, we plan to head into production, and then we want to continue our marketing and begin our sales at local farmers markets. We then want to continue to develop our new flavors, and our big goal at the moment is to sell in local grocery stores such as Tom's Market, and we're currently in contact with a manager at a local Trader Joe's, and she says that if we can use PFAS-free packaging as well as all-natural ingredients, she can help us get into the Small Potential Vendors program through Trader Joe's, which would give us an opportunity to sell in Trader Joe's. We have no doubt that if we were to go home fully funded tonight, we could add more events, gain more sales opportunities, as well as speed up our production.
Okay, it's my slide. We are asking for $5,000. The bulk of this money will be going to our packaging and manufacturing. Then other important costs it will be going to is getting a rental kitchen so we can test out more flavors and more new equipment, flavor testing ingredients, LLC registration, our tables at farmers markets, and the permits to be able to sell at farmers markets.
Thank you.
Now cover your ears for our big kapop. Any questions?
Did I miss how much you were selling it for? And that gets you what? So $8.99, and then is that a box of 6? Okay. So 83 cents per container is the cost. I just wasn't real clear on that. I didn't see
83 cents per unit. That's including the packaging and ingredients.
And that's just one bag.
That's for
of popcorn.
One box of popcorn.
Okay.
Yes.
All
for
right.
One bag.
Good. Got it. I will say I've tried both flavors. If you stopped at the lemon and the churro, I mean, I'd be happy. They're actually very good. It's no joke. This stuff's good. So, if you're able, and tell maybe explain a little bit more about the Vision and the other, what was the other store? What was it called? Tom's Market and Trader Joe's. So with the Tom's Market, which one can you get in faster? I mean, I'm sure Trader Joe's takes a little bit of time, but are you able to get in somewhere pretty quickly? Like if we handed you the money, you got everything you needed to do. I mean, you've already shown us you know how to make the product. I've tried it several times. But which one do you envision getting in the quickest, and how long do you think it would take?
So for Trader Joe's, we're not certain on the timeline yet because once we get into the program, we'll know more about that. And Tom's Market, our mentor, has been in contact with them. But we want, for the time being, we want to start selling at local farmers markets, because we can directly get into that like at the moment right now. And so we want to do that while we wait for the time to get into those bigger places so we can still have sales, and then we'll get to those bigger places and make even more.
Okay. And with the packaging, I know that you've showed us like a, you know, mock-up of the packaging. How, when like you can't do a prototype of that now because you need the money. Is that what it is? Is there like a minimum?
Okay. So for our packaging, we are very big on, so most popcorn packaging includes the ingredient PFAS. Carly knows how to pronounce the whole word, but the big thing is it's like, it's every single place uses it. That's one reason why Trader Joe's is somewhere we want to get in. They have no microwavable popcorn at Trader Joe's. You go to their popcorn aisle, there will be no microwavable, because PFAS is toxic for the environment, it's toxic for your body, it's toxic all around. We are going to be making our own packaging, and so we have ideas, like some of my friends are asking for it, so I just give them the seasoning blend and all that, and I have a homemade bag. But we're going to need to, over the summer, work to get those bags like actually made. It shouldn't be that difficult of a process. I already have tons of ideas. We're getting in contact with a packaging engineer. We're in contact, so we're going to try and get everything done over the summer. And as soon as that's done, Trader Joe's, I think she said, as soon as we have our packaging done, they can get us up to like, it will be, we could get in a year if we do everything right.
We do have a packaging mock-up of our box. We left it on our table when we were cleaning it up, so we do have that. We just don't have a packaging mock-up of our of the actual microwavable bags. We have plans on how to make those things.
I just want to add that I told you this last week, but I love the brand. I love the marketing that you have going so far. I wish we could take these into the audience and let everybody smell it. It smells so good. It tastes good, but it also smells really good. So great job with that. I know you said you'd be satisfied with the churro and lemon, but when you're talking about developing additional flavors, I know jalapeno, what is your like dream number of flavors that you guys are hoping to get to?
We hope to develop a range of flavors. Our dream before we launch, if possible, we hope to have a launching three. And then after that, we want to move into seasonal flavors and as many flavors as we can make. There's a huge market for flavored popcorn, and I've had, we did an event just today, and I had tons of people coming up asking what the new flavors were going to be. I've had so many people recommend flavors, and I think there's an infinite number of flavors we can make, and we have the ability to make it.
That part of the process will be a lot of fun. We buy the popcorn salt right now so I can put it on top, right? Like the cheddar flavor, jalapeno, and that kind of good stuff. So it'd be awesome for it to all be in one package. So great job.
And that's it. Those are the top 5 teams of the Vandegrift Incubator Program. Which of these ones will you see on Shark Tank? Did you get your first look at the new Amazon, Apple, or Torchies? All right, we're going to give our panels a few minutes to deliberate if y'all want to go ahead and head out. Yeah, of course. But I don't envy them for having to make that decision. Can I have a round of applause for all of these kids? I do have to say that we couldn't be more successful this year without our amazing volunteers. If you've served as a mentor, coach, pitch practice volunteer, or otherwise been in the classroom working with these amazing kids, could you please stand up? Okay. While the judges deliberate, let's see what Accelerator Team MIST was up to this school year.
Hi, we're MIST. I'm Mina, the CEO.
I'm Akshay, and I'm the COO.
And I'm Kyle Wilson, the CFO.
And our mentor is Ms. Frierson. So, to tell you a little bit about our company, MIST is an all-natural mosquito repellent free of DEET and other harmful chemicals. Our current product is made out of essential oils and rosemary hydrosol. Some of the essential oils that we use include lavender, lemon eucalyptus, citronella, tea tree, and sweetgrass.
Some things we accomplished this year and throughout the entrepreneurship program include making our business official, increasing our follower count by more than 150, and testing our product through samples.
For our website, we decided to make a very natural color tone. As you can see, scrolling down, we have some real customer reviews. And going to the shop tab, you can actually see our product on sale right now. And we wanted to make it very simple for them to find out any information they need to know. And the last contact is the contact information for us, for any information they might want to know about the product. And they can also see their shopping tab.
In my entrepreneurship class, I learned a lot about market research, business planning, financing, branding, and marketing. But aside from that, I learned so much about how to create a team and contribute to important projects. But by far the most valuable thing I learned was how to put myself and my ideas out there.
Hey guys, it's Akshay. Just wanted to talk about some things that I learned from Incubator and the opportunities I got from Incubator. Without Incubator, I would have never been able to start a business, which was my first experience in doing so. Without Incubator, I would have never learned the value of trial and error and not giving up, considering our team had to go through 3 products to get to the right one. And without Incubator, I wouldn't have met such a wonderful and loving community of students and teachers. So yeah.
The entrepreneurship program is an amazing program. Some of the skills that I've learned from my experience in this program include presentation skills, interpersonal skills, teamwork, and leadership. Without this program, I wouldn't have had the opportunity to learn how to start a small business at such a young age. And I wouldn't have been able to work with such amazing mentors and teachers. Thank you to everyone who helped us throughout this entire journey. Thank you, Ms. Mathis, Ms. Lucas, and Ms. Frierson for all your support and advice.
Thank you to Ms. Frierson, Ms. Lucas, and Ms. Mathis. We couldn't have done it without y'all.
I'd like to take the time to thank Mrs. Frierson, Mrs. Lucas, and Mrs. Mathis so much for helping us get into Accelerator. Thank you so much. It's been an incredible experience.
Wow, the evening is quickly coming to an end. Here is Slap Daddy to tell us what we have accomplished this school year.
Hello, my name is Christian Long.
I'm Vince Cuthbert.
I'm Alex Mockov.
And we are the founders of Slap Daddy Koozies.
This fall, I'll be attending Texas A&M and studying pre-law.
I'm going to Ole Miss to study entrepreneurship. Hot dog.
I'll be attending Texas A&M to study economics. Gigamags.
As last year's pitch champions, all eyes were on us to see what we would make of it.
Since then, we've created a website with over thousands of dollars in sales, and we've been pumping up our social media accounts.
After our persistent effort, we've been successful in getting our products into several stores in the local area, including the Oasis Gift Shop and VIP Marinas. We're also having conversations with stores like Tyler's and other smaller gas stations. Some of our dream collaborations are going to be with our future school, Texas A&M, and Bucky's gas stations across Texas and the South.
And Ole Miss!
Let's check out the warehouse.
Follow me.
Let him cook!
Here's our stock, it's running low, so go get yourself one at slap-daddy.com. We got more styles coming soon this summer.
Huge shout out to Ms. Mathis and Ms. Lucas for all of their help as our teachers these past 2 years. And thank you to all the volunteers, all the judges, coaches, and mentors for always being there for us and giving us all the input. We would not be where we are today without them. And a huge shout out to those top 5 teams presented tonight. Y'all go crush it.
Go check out what we're up to on Instagram at slapdaddy.ig
and our TikTok at slapdaddy.official.
See ya.
See ya.
We would like to welcome to the stage our classroom teachers, the Aaron. Hello. All right. So last week, after the teams pitched, we always ask the judges to give spread the warmth a little bit. And so they do non-monetary awards
to all the teams, so all 22 teams that pitched last week. So I'm going to call some teams out and some awards. If we call your name, we will have the team stand up, and then we will have these awards for you in class tomorrow. All right, they voted for Best Prototype. Best Prototype went to Armadillo. Quickest to Market went to Organic Refresh. Best Presentation went to Port-A-Hoop. Best Premium Product went to Legacy. Most Improved Since MVP Pitch went to Firebox. And the one that you all voted on, People's Choice Award, also went to Armadillo. Congratulations, guys.
Okay, congratulations to those teams. So the team that wins the top tonight, which we'll know shortly when the judges come back, they'll turn around and create a video presentation that will be submitted to National Incubator. As Vandegrift's submission for the National Pitch Competition in Chicago on July 11th. If one of our teams makes it, they'll submit it in around 200 teams from across the country, also submit a video. If they make it, the team will have the opportunity to go to Chicago and earn more funding and lots of other great things. So now,
now, as we said, the commitment of volunteers is vital to the program. This year, more than 90 of y'all signed up to serve as our mentors and coaches. Let's recognize all of the students that have participated in this program as well. If you're currently a student in the incubator program, please stand. Panel, are we ready? Okay, they're not ready. Give them a minute. Wow, must be a really tight competition with how long it's taking. I guess just wait longer. I don't really know. While we're waiting, let's have the top five teams come assemble on the stage. stand in front of the screen so they can get a good picture.
All right, guys, while we're waiting, let's give this group another round of applause. These five teams will be our next accelerator class. So they've all earned a spot into the class next year. We will spend their senior year setting up LLCs and launching and continuing their entrepreneurial journey their senior year. Very, very proud of them. I think it gets better every year, the competition. And I think this group's going to do some amazing things. So once again, let's give them a huge applause. And I can testify in 5 years, it has never taken this long in judge deliberation. So that's just a testament in how well they've done. Now I'd like to turn over the mic to Mr. Agnew.
Is he here?
Here he comes.
Here he is. Everyone give him a round of applause.
You got it? Oh, almost let the cat out of the bag there. Sorry. Where do y'all want me? Okay, I'll stay over here. You hold it. You go back. I'm gonna give it away. First of all, I want to say thank you to the Aarons, Miss Lucas, Miss Mathis, for being the teachers in this program. I've been with them since the beginning, and it has been an amazing time. Golly, how many teams is that? Like 20 to 25 teams every year. So I've had the opportunity to work with every single team that has come through this program since the first year. And it has just gotten better every year. And I'm not going to lie, this year was absolutely the hardest year for us to pick, you know, from these teams. And there's teams that aren't even on this stage tonight that have businesses that could be right up here. Like, this is the best group I've ever seen. So congratulations to y'all. Like, you did some amazing stuff this year. You guys dug in. You worked hard. You did your research. And you brought some really cool products for us to see, and I'm going to be a customer for some of the businesses here. So I just want to say thank y'all for being good kids, and I've enjoyed this. So anyway, so now, without further ado, We will start with fifth place, and this will receive $1,000. This is Exuberance. So $1,000 for that. Fourth place is going to go to Porta Hoop, and you will receive $2,000. So you guys get $2,000. Third place is going to go to Kapopcorn for $2,000. And then, so now we've got the drum roll thing going on here, whatever that's supposed to be. Yeah, everybody drum roll. Ready? So, second place is Cup Fitly, which means our winner is K9. Cup Fitly, you will receive $3,000. And K9, you guys are going to get $4,000. $4,000. So here we go. Good job. Congratulations, guys. Y'all did an amazing job. All of y'all did amazing. And I'll just say one thing. Don't beat yourself up. There's a whole lot that goes into this decision. It's all about where everybody's at and how quick they can get to market. It's also whether or not you can get your product like to the masses quickly. And so that's part of the decision. It was very, very hard, believe me. Like, we were struggling back there. A lot of pressure. So anyway, congratulations, guys. And you guys are all going on to the accelerator. So congratulations. And thank you all for coming. We appreciate it.
Guys, let's give a big hand to our MCs, too. They just told me that I'm going to miss them next year, and I think they're right.
Come this way. Dad.